the ROTC.
All right, the ROTC of Shelton High School in marching formation. Looking very professional out there, aren't they, A-Ray?
Yeah, they're all in uniform and ready to go. I wonder if that'd be a warm outfit to be wearing.
I think it might be a little warm. They got the khaki tops and the black bottoms.
I like the hats.
They are in marching formation. Hey, I wanted to remind you while we had a little break in the action here this morning that we got a notification from Patty Case at Green Diamond Resource Company. And you know, Amanda, we have our own Paul Bunyan, right?
Right.
Well, as we might be thinking, Paul needs a companion.
Everybody needs a companion.
Everybody needs somebody sometime. Paul needs the Babe the Blue Ox, and the Babe the Blue Ox project is on. And coming up here in a little bit, I'm going to tell you about a special event that Green Diamond Resource Company is putting together to help get donations for Babe the Blue Ox to go along with.
Very cool, very cool. We'll take a second here to listen to the Department of Washington American Legion Band now.
What do we have, Amanda?
It's the Department of Washington American Legion Band.
Let's take a listen. That is great stuff, the American Legion Marching Band.
That looks a little bit more like John Tarrant than the last folks we saw.
Here comes Mayor Tarrant now.
The 2011 Grand Marshal of the Forest Festival Parade, John Tarrant, the mayor of Shelton. He's waving to everyone as he rides on by. Now, I don't know a whole lot about cars, but that one's pretty nice.
Well, I'm going to say that's a probably 64 Buick, Diedrich, 64, 63. Buick Skylark convertible with the Honorable John Tarrant, Mayor of Shelton, riding on the, riding, not shotgun, but he's there.
He's there.
All right.
Coming by next, we have the official Forest Festival float, and on it, your 2011 Forest Festival royalty. Alyssa Cervantes, Queen of the Forest and her court, Caitlin Freeman, Princess of Hemlock, Brianna Eddy, Princess of Cedar, Amanda Brain, Princess of Douglas Fir, Hannah Mikowitz, Princess of Spruce, and Sean Rogers, Smokey Bear.
I gotta tell you, Amanda, that's a totally world-class float. That looks nice.
That is, they look so pretty up there.
I mean, I'm like, wow.
And the 2011 float is titled Forest Tales. It was designed and built by Lynn Freeman, who's the mom of one of the princesses, Caitlin. I like that float.
I know. I mean, that could be in any major parade, yeah, I would think, like even the Rose Parade.
You could see that at the Rose Parade.
You could. Hey, Amanda, let's talk about Smokey Bear and Paul Bunyan, who's coming right up. Not
right.
The big, tall Paul Bunyan, but our honorary Paul Bunyan.
We can't reveal the big, tall Paul Bunyan until the end.
I know.
So
this log truck is brought to you with the logs from Green Diamond Resource Company. And who is our local Paul Bunyan for this year?
The Paul Bunyan for the year is Kirk Taylor, riding high atop the Forest Festival sponsor, Green Diamond's logging truck.
That is very, very cool.
I didn't even know he was up there for
a second
because of our tent.
Him.
So I'm trying to find him up there. There he is.
You're like, what are you talking about?
I don't know about this Paul Bunyan character. Okay. Coming by next, we have the Shelton High School Marching Band and Color Guard. A fun fact, my roommate is actually the coach of the Color Guard.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah.
I did not know that. How would I?
She is. How would you know that?
Now, you were in the Color Guard or the Marching Band or no?
Oh, no.
At Shelton High School?
No.
Mark?
Never in the Color Guard or the
softball.
Marching Band. Yeah, I played softball.
Cheerleader? No.
None of those things.
Is your roommate out here now?
She is. She's right there. She's not looking.
I know.
Nope, she doesn't want to pay attention. Oh, there we go. Hi, Tyler.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Shelton High School Marching Band. Coming up on the weekend of July 15th, Amanda, the 15th through the 17th, they're having the the Shelton High School Super Reunion. This is like classes 1960 through 1979.
So like 20 years worth of classes there?
Yeah, exactly.
Wow.
1960 to 1979.
Very cool.
Shelton High School Super Reunion. How are you guys doing? All right, good.
It's going to be out of the Little Creek Casino.
Yeah.
It's called Rockin' and Roll into the 60s and 70s, which only makes sense.
I mean, what a neat deal, though. 20 years of class reunion. That's huge.
If you are a part of one of those classes, you can register at sheltonhigh.com.
And why wouldn't you want to?
I would, but a little early.
Loads of fun. Hey, what's up next, Amanda?
Looks like coming up next, we have the U.S. Navy Forks Old Fashioned. Okay, we have the Forks Old Fashioned 4th of July celebration. They're celebrating the freedom and heritage of our country and honoring hometown heroes.
Ah, the Forks Old Fashioned 4th of July. How you doing? Good.
Also a part of that are the Friends of Willie and Joe, a World War II living history group sanctioned by Bill Mauldin, who created the cartoon Soldiers, Willie and Joe. And the cartoon was published in Stars and Stripes. The group leader and founder is Stephen Gay. That's very patriotic.
Now, what's that?
It's patriotic. Now, it makes me think of 4th of July.
You didn't know about that old Buick that we had up here a while
no,
ago?
No,
it's like in 1964. Now we get some vehicles like from the 1940s, Amanda.
Yeah.
These are like World War II era Jeeps from the Army, Friends of Willie and Joe.
I just want to drive one of those around town.
I know. It's like a Humvee of the 1940s.
I think it'd be fun.
Really?
And they wear the outfit. You know what it makes me think of? Is that's pretty cool.
So, yeah, they got these totally cool World War II Jeeps. Now, here comes a truck. On the front, it says 8-Ball.
Wow.
Maybe it's a V8.
Maybe.
Very authentic. I mean, down to the paint job, the emblems, and the uniforms the officers have there.
It's just cool that they've lasted for so long and make them look so nicely.
But I think one of those Jeeps would be kind of nice for, like, after the parade because it's so nice out today, like convertible, you know.
Just ride around the lake or something in your nice Jeep.
Whatever you want to do.
We got a little break in the action here. Tell me more about Paul Bunyan's companion.
Well, here's the thing is Patty Case and Green Diamond Resources have decided that they put out a public challenge. And that public challenge is they will match up to $2,000 toward the manufacture and the purchase of a Babe the Blue Ox.
Very cool. So where can we donate?
Well, you can donate right now wherever you see Paul Bunyan. There's an actual donation box on his trailer. And you can also go to the our community credit union at Heritage Bank. There
Come
is
on,
a
Shelton, let me hear you
an account set up there.
Ronald McDonald is stealing the show here. He's direct from McDonaldland. Ronald McDonald, he's on a Segway.
Ronald McDonald.
I like the Segway.
House.
Hey, it's Jerry.
Hey, Jerry Lingle.
Yeah, Mason County Commissioner, District 3, Jerry
All
Lingle.
Right. And that is, I can tell you right now, Amanda, that's a 65. Chevelle Malibu.
Very nice.
396, four on the floor.
Very nice.
Not a super sport model.
Oh, is there? There's a difference?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Don Ponell coming through now,
the
City of Shelton Commissioner.
That's going to be what, Diedrich, is 62 T-Bird ish? Somewhere in there?
It's a cream colored old car.
What do I know?
What do we know?
I mean, really. Anyway, on the Paul Bunyan companion, Babe the Blue Ox. Up to $2,000 of public donations, Green Diamond's going to match that. And this is going to be a very huge deal because it'll be a nice companion piece to our very own, 30-foot Paul Bunyan? Something like that, 20-something?
He's pretty tall.
But everybody needs somebody. And
yeah,
he needs
Babe the Blue Ox.
It makes me,
I thought Babe the Pig for a while. I
know,
I don't know.
You're like, okay, Babe.
It's a pig?
I don't know. No, Babe's actually the Blue Ox.
All right. We have some horses coming by now. It's the Equestrian of Mason County. They're marching behind their banner carried by two forest maidens, and Snow White has lost her seven dwarves.
Uh-oh.
But the Wicked Witch has caught up to her. Robin Hood, Maid Marian, and Friar Truck rode in to save her. We have the Queen of the Fairies, Tatiana, rides with her fairy godmother, Rapunzel. And Little Red Riding Hood seems to have tamed the Big Bad Wolf. So basically, we have all of the different characters
yeah,
out here today.
Yeah, a little of everything. And Rapunzel, I mean, her hair really is long.
Yeah, it really is long. And just to keep it current, two vampires leading their pack of werewolves.
Oh, good.
Yeah. Had to keep up the Twilight references throughout the day.
Well, coming up next, we have the Sanderson Field RC Flyers. But back to this Green Diamond project, you can make your donation by going to the Paul Bunyan trailer that he travels on, which is now by the clock tower where our DJ Dale's doing the parade announcing.
Yes.
Or you can go to the our community credit union, Heritage Bank, and there's an account set up in the name of Babe the Blue Ox Project.
So hopefully a year from now when we're doing the parade, Paul Bunyan will have a friend.
Exactly.
Babe the Blue Ox.
Because right now,
he's probably lonely.
He's lonely. I mean, he's huge. He's like 25 feet tall.
Yeah.
What's he going to do?
I'm not sure these bikes are part of the parade, but we have some bikes going by.
Yeah, they're doing some tomfoolery, some trickery riding there. Hey, again, our sponsors for our parade broadcast on 1030 KMAS this morning. I want to thank Green Diamond Resource Company, Generation D Computers, The Roof Doctor, and Treasures Thrift Store. Take a break. And we'll be back with more parade coverage on 1030 KMAS. And thank you to our parade's broadcast sponsors this afternoon. They are Green Diamond Resource Company, Generation D Computers, The Roof Doctor, and Treasures Thrift Store. Amanda Ray, what have we got sailing up here now?
I'm unsure. Just catch up on a couple of the things that we missed while we were on the break. The Kiwanis Clowns. Those are always some of my favorites.
Oh,
so I have to mention it.
They're wacky.
Also, the Queens of the Forest, Taylor Roebacker from 2010, Kaylee Bogue from 2009, and Patsy Bixenman from 1965, North Mason High School. Oh, we have a song. The Green Ministry, Food Bank, Clothing Closet. There's Adoption Ministry. They're singing a song atop of a float for us right out here now. And now we get some more logging trucks coming down this way. Have you ever driven a logging truck?
I have ridden in a logging truck. My grand, or my uncle, my dad's brother used to drive a lowboy for Weyerhaeuser.
I've never even been inside of one.
I got to get inside and ride, I was 13, 14 maybe.
Very nice.
Very cool. And this is Mankey Lumber Company, truck number 63, Peterbilt.
A 60-foot log truck right there.
Land Lumber Logs, proudly supporting the community since 1950.
Very nice.
That's Mankey Lumber Company. I think we got some of the older trucks coming our way now, Amanda.
Yeah, some of the older Mankey Lumber trucks. There's a 1973 Peterbilt 60-foot log truck coming on our way.
Nice.
Also, just a 30-foot lumber truck. That one looks a little newer, I'd say. We don't have a year here, but it's definitely not
old. That truck there. Now we got a Garrett classic grader. It's called the Tree Farmer.
That's the one from 1973.
That is very, very cool.
Yeah.
And either these have been taken extremely good care of, A-Ray, or they were totally cherried out.
I was
going
to say,
right?
Perfectly good condition, especially for 1973.
They went to, like, Rick on American Restoration and had him take care of it or something. Well, here comes another Peterbilt from Mankey Lumber. Amanda, isn't that 1973, you think?
Yeah.
I bet it is.
I'll bet it is also.
That is sweet.
That one's from Tacoma. They have Tacoma, Shelton.
Thank you, Mankey Lumber.
Remember when you were younger and you always used to do the arm signal to try to make the semi-trucks honk?
Exactly.
Yeah.
And they always would.
They always would.
And why wouldn't they?
Yeah.
Hey, a couple of quick reminders for you while we're waiting for another marching band here. The carnival is going on starting at noon today at the Gateway Center on Olympic Highway North, going until 11 o'clock tonight. Logging show at Luke Field at 2 this afternoon, and food, arts, and crafts, and more. Now we welcome from the north end of the county,
The North Mason High School Band, directed by Leah Thomas and marching with Bulldog Pride. It's a 50-member band, assisted by drum majors David Hicks and Anissa Adams. So here, we'll take a listen to that.
I gotta say, they're sounding pretty tight.
They do. They sound very good today.
Excellent.
Very good.
North Mason Marching Band.
Coming through next, we have Wanda Sheets. She is driving her purple 1940 four-door coupe. Oh, that has a pretty good horn, too.
Yeah. And sadly, he left his coffee cup on top of the... Oh, never mind. I think it's glued.
I think it's glued there. Did we already talk about the fireworks show tonight? That's one of my favorite parts of Forest Festival.
Yeah, that's going to be like a little after dusk, 10 o'clock.
About 10 o'clock at Oakland Blade Junior High Field, so just past Walmart on Wallace Neyland Boulevard. I can always hear them. No matter where you are, even if you're not there, you can hear them at about 10 o'clock.
Now, you've probably been to many a firework display there since growing up in Shelton. Right?
I've been to a few, yeah. I've been to a few there. I think they get better every year.
Relay for Life, Amanda, is a huge undertaking in both Shelton for Mason County and North Mason. And here comes some representatives from the Relay for Life of Mason County.
Yeah, so the vintage Pepsi truck that we're seeing will tow a playhouse that is being raffled off. The Relay for Life is in its 11th year. It'll be held June 24th and 25th at the Shelton High School track. So come out and support this great cause. And the Relay for Life is a great cause.
Relay for Life is just blown up.
Benefiting the American Cancer Society.
For research, education, funding the American Cancer Society. We have now the Miss American Rose Royalty.
They are so cute. America's largest online / mail-in achievement pageant. They recognize and reward girls and women for their accomplishments. They're adorable.
They are cute. How old are these girls? Maybe seven?
I'd say seven, eight. Yeah, I'd say seven or eight.
And you're right. Adorable is doesn't even begin to describe. And the cars are so cute. What are those little Miatas?
I think so. Yeah, the little Miatas. This one coming up, though, is different. It's Kitsap's Peninsula's Outstanding Teen of 2011.
Yeah, so, she's not seven.
She's not seven. Angela White and her Pinecone Princess Emily. They came through for us.
Very excellent. Anyway, back to the fireworks. It's a great venue for fireworks.
It is. There's a big space, a huge field. If you go by earlier in the day, you can see them setting it up, and they literally have just fireworks across the entire field that are ready to be lit off. So it's pretty cool.
It's going to be awesome.
Yeah.
Well, what a great clear night for it and everything.
Yeah, 79 for a high today.
How sweet it is.
Definitely.
I'm not kidding.
77
yeah.
tomorrow. Perfect weekend for Forest Festival.
Yeah, like it for the Forest Festival and just kind of getting out and about and all the different things that are going on. Amanda, real quick, also tonight the Family Fun Night's happening.
Yes.
And that's going to be where? Gateway, is that right?
Family Fun Night from 7 to 10, a countdown to the fireworks display. So it's happening at our Community Credit Union on Olympic Highway North. And the sponsors of that Family Fun Night include the Squaxin Island Child Development Center, Lynch Creek Floral, Mankey Lumber Company, Cutray Auto Parts, Pro Build of Shelton, and Shelton Life.
And Shelton Life, I got to tell you, I've been reading it. It's a good little weekly publication that comes out.
I haven't
out.
Got a chance to check it out yet.
Really? You know, they did a nice spread on DJ Dale, our station owner.
Oh, KMAS. Yes, I did. I lied. I saw that.
And, so it's very great.
Very Stephanie, cool.
Stephanie Horton and the crew doing an awesome job. What do we got coming up now, Amanda?
Coming up now, looks like we have the Mason County Sheriff's Office. There's a few different things that are coming through. The light armored vehicle, which is assigned to SWAT.
I got to go in that thing during the fair. It is so cool.
It looks pretty cool. Oh. Also, the Mason County Search and Rescue coming by, reminding you always wear your life jacket, which is very important. Especially as the weather's getting warmer and everything, people are going to be out boating and jet skiing, tubing, all kinds of activities.
So this is the Mason County Sheriff's Office rescue boat, is that right?
Yeah, it's the Marine Enforcement Deputy.
Amanda, I don't know if you're aware, but I'm with the Shelton Police Department Citizens Academy.
This is what I've heard.
I got to drive that Dodge Magnum last Wednesday up at the State Patrol training facility.
Very nice. Was it fun? Did you feel important?
I didn't. I felt like a kid because they said, hey, Roach, you can't take it on the fast part of the track, but you can go drive like 10 miles an hour through the
cones. You know that Sanderson Field is where everyone goes to learn how to drive. Like before you're allowed on the railroad, that's where you go out to.
Exactly. Search and Rescue.
Yes.
Underrated, and a lot of people don't know about what they do, but they have done and saved many a life, and this is the Mason County Search and Rescue
Mason Squad. County Search and Rescue mobile units coming by. Lots of sirens.
Amanda, I think this may be a very good time to break away for just a couple of seconds here. And
I would agree.
To, our live parade coverage brought to you by?
Brought to you by Green Diamond Resource Company, Generation D Computers, The Roof Doctor, and Treasures Thrift Store.
And it's all right here on 1030 KMAS.
Take punishment and had to settle down. Now I'm playing it.
what an awesome day we have for it. What did you say, Amanda, like 80 today?
It's supposed to be 80 for a high, so we'll see.
Beautiful. Hey, we want to take a minute just to thank our sponsors for our parade broadcast, because it means a lot to us at 1030 KMAS, and they are Green Diamond Resource Company, Generation D Computers, The Roof Doctor, and Treasures Thrift Store. Miss Amanda.
Yeah, let's take a listen now to the North Mason 4th and 5th grade band out of Belfair, Washington, directed by Stan Yantis. They're sounding really good.
Yeah, they do. Here we go. Awesome.
They do. They sound very awesome.
What you just heard passing by our reviewing stand here are fourth and fifth graders from North Mason.
Starting out young. If you start that young, imagine how good they'll be by high school.
I know.
Very cool.
That's amazing.
Coming by next, we have the Southside School District. And is that, are they Tigers?
I am going to say it looks like a tiger to me, Amanda.
It is a tiger. And it's the, oh, it's a bobcat.
Who knew?
The Southside Bobcats. I did know that, actually. It's the Forest Festival Court up there. Looking very, very beautiful. We have some princesses, the queen, I think, up there. I always wanted to wear one of the tiaras.
I know.
Yeah.
And I could see you with the, what do you call this thing?
The sash.
The sash.
Yeah, I never did, though.
I could see you in that. And I was wondering, do you have the wave down the whole?
No, I was never very good at the wave. That is a big truck.
Okay, and what's that all
it's
about?
It's Greg Coverdale, his 1999 Ford F-250 with a 21-inch lift and 50-inch tires.
Okay, I could go under that truck just by crouching down and walk from one side of it to the other.
You could do the limbo under that truck.
I wonder how much those tires cost.
I don't know.
$7,000 each.
It's a high truck.
Definitely. All right, Olympic National Forest, Amanda. This is their fire engine.
Oh, you can hear it.
Part of the U.S. Forest Service Department of Agriculture.
Very nice.
That is nice.
I like the color. It's not. Oh, we just had a firefighter jump on the truck while
I
it was moving.
That. A little acrobatic.
You don't see that every day.
Going on.
So we just saw a couple minutes ago the North Mason band directed by Stan Yantis. Now going by the Hawkins Middle School flag team, also directed by Stan Yantis. He's a busy guy.
He is a busy guy.
Coming up next, the Hawkins Middle School marching band, which he also directs.
Oh, stop.
Yeah.
Why wouldn't he?
Home of the Huskies.
So where is Stan? We got to get this guy on the air with us.
Apparently. I haven't actually seen him yet.
Or he's actually too busy to go on with us. So coming up, what is the Hawkins Middle School marching band? Let's give it a listen.
They're doing Lady Gaga.
There they go, the Hawkins Middle School marching band directed by
Stan Yantis.
And why wouldn't they be? Hey, they have a great festival in Tacoma. It's called the Daffodil Festival, Amanda.
This year their float is the Spirit of Adventure, welcoming Queen Claire and two of her royal court princesses, and the 2011 Daffodil Festival Traveling Float. It features, which we have coming up here shortly, a hot air balloon. These young women are on their own adventure of a lifetime. With the float is Ron Jensen, who's the 2011 Daffodil Festival president. So this float that we're seeing has, of course, a lot of daffodils, but also a real live hot air balloon.
And they are always, Amanda, one of our premier entries in any parade. They go to the Lilac Festival in Spokane.
Right.
Loggers Play Day in Hoquiam. And here is the Daffodil Festival Float, sponsored in part by the Emerald Queen Casino.
They have some choreography, too. Just got some high fives from a guy wearing a daffodil on his head.
Always very much a class act, the Daffodil Festival Float. And the local Tacoma Daffodilians.
I really like that one.
I like their yellow coats.
Yeah, I like it a lot.
What do you think?
So you should try one of those, maybe later tonight.
Would it make me look like a giant bumblebee or something? I don't know if that's my color.
Yeah, maybe not.
I'm just saying, I'm a big guy. I don't know.
Well, you're wearing a bright yellow shirt right now.
I know, exactly. Welcome from Grace Harbor, the rodeo court, Amanda.
Yes, the 2011 rodeo queen, Ashley King from Montesano, and Princess Madison Weber from Elma. The Grace Harbor Rodeo is held each March. They're dressed in some cowboy attire. They got their boots on and their cowboy hats. They have some saddles up there. They look like they're ready to go ride some horses.
And picture this, they're on a flatbed. Sitting on bales of hay with saddles. Great bunch of girls.
Very nice.
Grace Harbor Rodeo Court. Amanda, coming up next, we have the Grace Harbor. I was talking about Loggers Play Day a little while ago.
Yeah.
It's come and play on Labor Day in Hoquiam, Loggers Play Day. And here comes their float.
Very nice.
Let's talk about that a little
bit. Yeah, it's featuring a 1951 Kenworth truck pulling a 1965 Tillman trailer. And it's equipped with an 1899 steam donkey used in the early days of logging. The royalty court that's going by us right now consists of Princesses Amanda Turpin, Billie Jean Turpin, Kelsey Anderson, and Kim Downing. So the Loggers Play Day again, September 10th, 2011 in Hoquiam. So they want everybody to come out and see that.
Now, I don't know what year this truck is, Amanda, but I do know that it's from our local cable company, Hood Canal Communications, Channel 43.
Hood Canal Communications, yeah. And going by with the truck is some of the employees of Hood Canal Communications and their kids. So,
Amanda, when I say cuddly bear ice cream, what comes to mind?
Cuddly bear ice cream? An ice cream truck. You know how they always drive through the neighborhoods with their music?
I know.
You run out of your house and you have to just like find a quarter or something before you can run down the road really fast. It's a 1979 DJ5 Jeep. I want them to, they're not playing their music though.
So Good Humor Ice Cream, Cuddly Bear Ice Cream is our current float that's, not float, but entry that's coming by us here at our broadcast location today. Clallam County Royalty, Amanda.
Yeah, the reigning queen, Marissa Wilson, and Princess Stephanie Lindquist, and then the 2011 candidates, Brooklyn Bauer, Ruby Jackson, and Caitlin Nord. The Clallam County Fair is August 18th through the 21st, and they're asking you to come rock with the stock.
Rock with the stock, I like
that. I like the colors on there.
Oh, yeah.
They have some pink and some turquoise color, some purple.
Yeah. Gosh, that's a nice little float. They got like an inflatable jukebox on there, too. So that's a lot of fun.
Again, August 18th through 21st, the Clallam County Fair.
Amanda, I'm going to ask you a question.
Okay.
Do you feel like clowning around a little bit?
Always.
Well, guess what's coming down the pike?
Yes. One of my favorite entries in all of the parades, the Shelton Rotary. And they always dress as clowns.
You know, I used to drive a little Datsun that looked a lot like that. Is that a little Datsun? Yeah.
Did it, was it the same colors, you know? The lovely striped colors?
No, mine was just orange.
Just orange.
But actually, that's a Toyota Corolla, my mistake. But Shelton Rotary Clowns, always a fun entry.
Are you one of those people that's a little freaked out by clowns?
I do have an unnatural fear of them, I think. Would I have some artwork in my house that's like clowns? No, I wouldn't.
No, I wouldn't. I wouldn't either.
A little freaky.
They're kind of scary.
I know.
Yeah.
Oh, my. Thank you. We just got a up close and personal.
With the clown.
With the clown.
Yeah.
All
you never
right,
know
Amanda,
what could happen.
Mason County Fire District
11. Their brush fire engine. And they just want to thank you for all you do.
Well, we want to certainly thank them for all that they
do.
Yeah,
let's
for
thank
sure.
them
yeah.
for all they do.
Forget what we do. I mean,
what do we do?
What do I know? So now I think we have Mason County Fire District
13.
Number 13, is that right?
Yeah.
Let's talk about this a little bit. Huge truck. I think we take for granted a lot of things that, you know, that they do for the public and
definitely.
When they spring into action on emergencies.
Yeah. So
let's recognize Mason County Fire District 13. Mason County Medic 1.
Want to thank them for all they do as well. All of these guys.
Here comes number 5.
Mason County Fire District number 5.
Hey, Diedrich. This morning was it the retirement breakfast for Dave Salzer?
Yes, it was.
And that was over at the new fire department?
That's correct.
Is Dave up here on this truck, or did you see him?
I saw him, but I didn't ask if he's going to be in the parade.
Okay. Well, here comes the huge truck with District 5.
That scared me. I wasn't expecting the horn.
I know. Well, you were listening to continuing coverage of the 2011 Mason County Forest Festival Parade on 1030 KMAS Radio. Also online at KMAS.com and streaming audio and video at masonwebtv.com. Thank you for joining and thank you for viewing. What else is happening throughout the day today and even over the weekend, Amanda?
A lot of stuff going on. Yeah, tomorrow, which is supposed to be just as nice weather-wise as today, there's going to be a wood duck race at 3 in the afternoon, Goldsboro Creek, 7th to 1st Street, and it's going to be presented by the Christmastown Kiwanis. Also tomorrow, this is always a big deal around here, the Shelton Car Show-Off from 10 to 3 at Olympic Highway North. Registration from 8 to 11 in the parking lot of the Jerry's Drive-In.
Well, sadly, Jerry's Drive-In recently closed.
Right.
But if you're wondering where it is, it's the A&W.
It's still the A&W Jerry's Drive-In parking lot.
And according to our news director, Diedrich Allen, it's maybe easily hands down the best hot dog he ever had in his life. He was quite saddened by the closure of
Jerry's. I think everybody was.
Yeah.
Awards are going to be at 2 in the afternoon for the card show. And then also going on tomorrow, the Tour de Mason Lake. It's a 32-mile bike ride.
Now you're in that, no?
I'm not much of a bike rider.
You can run a marathon.
I can run a marathon, yeah. But I can't do the bike riding. But yeah. The registration, if you are interested, at 10 a.m. at Anytime Fitness on Olympic Highway North. Hey, I haven't rode a bike since I was about 10.
Oh, seriously?
Oh, yeah.
You have one now? We
should
go for
a ride. No, I don't have a bike.
Okay.
Yeah.
Hey, our parade.
Diedrich's going to hook me up so we can go for a ride.
I would love it. Our sponsors for our live parade broadcast, Green Diamond Resource Company. Also, thank you to Generation D Computers right next to the radio station, by the way, on Coda. The Roof Doctor and Treasures Thrift Store. And talking about thrift stores, Amanda, we have a good segue into our next parade entry.
Yeah, the Mason County Senior Activities Association and their Nifty 50 Ford truck with some of their friends along board. And they are from the Nifty Thrifty Thrift Store, 2505 Olympic Highway North, right behind McDonald's.
It's a nice little store. They've got quite a good selection of books, household appliances.
Let me just tell you, you can find some fantastic treasures at places, at thrift stores. You just never know what you can find.
Always.
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 Maybe I could find a bike.
Maybe you could. I think so. Amanda, this is an outstanding float that's coming up next. I want to say this is from way up north.
Yeah, the Squim Irrigation Festival float. The 2011 Squim Royalty with their float. And this year it's titled 100 and Sweet 16. So they have a carousel-looking It looks like it's maybe made out of like paper mache, but it's a carousel that is actually spinning around.
And that is very cool from the Squim Irrigation Festival, and they do have a world-class parade float, Amanda. I think you can see that in any parade around the country.
Definitely very nice. I like that the carousel is actually spinning.
That, and I think you like their theme song.
I
Girls do. Just Want to Have Fun.
It's a good one. That's a good one. Because they do.
I know. It's 12 noon. You're listening to 1030 KMAS Shelton, Olympia, Belfair, and you're listening to the Forest Festival Parade broadcast on 1030 KMAS.
Should we thank the parade broadcast sponsors again? The
Absolutely.
Green Diamond Resource Company, Generation D Computers, the Roof Doctor and Treasures Thrift Store, and thank them very much because without them, we wouldn't be doing this. So.
And Amanda, there's another thing. These are the major festival sponsors for the year, and we want to thank a few of them as we can throughout the afternoon.
Yes.
Graphic Communication, Digital Printing, Green Diamond Resource Company, Little Creek Casino Resort, Simpson and Shelton Rotary. Let's welcome our friends from ProBuild.
Yes. The Down Home Fiddle, Bluegrass, and Country Band atop the ProBuild truck. Enjoy their music. Let's take a listen to that.
Reminds me of Bluegrass from the Forest a couple of weeks ago.
Yeah.
Other sponsors, major sponsors for the festival include Mankey Lumber, Shelton Live, Shoppers Weekly, Gillis Auto Center, Skookum Rotary, Olympic Physicians, also Diamond Excavating, AAA Septic Pumping and Portable Potty LLC, and your local radio station. In fact, I would like to go on record by saying we are very proud to be sponsoring, and we are very proud to be in Shelton. We are KMAS Shelton Studios, located in Shelton, Washington. What's up next, Amanda?
The South Mason Youth Soccer Club. The Youth Soccer Club demonstrating their soccer skills along the way. So you see some people juggling the soccer balls, doing a little dribbling as they go down the road here. They're bringing along players from the Kitsap Pumas soccer team.
I know.
The professional team from Bremerton.
Did they beat Portland last night? Yeah, they beat the Portland Timbers U23 team 3-2. And Diedrich, what did they qualify for? Remind me again.
It's the U.S. Open Cup, the developmental league version of it.
They could potentially be playing the Seattle Sounders down the line, I heard. This is what I hear. This is what people tell me.
Very cool.
We had a travel trailer like that when I was like 8.
Yeah, did you go camping?
This is what we did, and this is Adopt-A-Pet.
It is Adopt-A-Pet. You can go to adoptapet.org. Adopt-A-Pet's a great organization. They help out a lot of animals that need good homes.
Aren't they, though?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's like a 1963 travel trailer, and I got to tell you, it's in pretty doggone good shape.
It works.
It ain't bad.
No. Coming up next, we have the Graham Hay Company. It's a Kenworth truck, lowboy, and equipment. Oh, man.
You think that's a big piece of equipment?
That is a big piece of equipment.
Wow.
What is that? Do you know what that does?
I don't know what the official name for it is, but it's some kind of excavating equipment. I don't know these things too much. I'm just a dumb old country boy. I don't know this technology. No, it's huge. It's massive. And kind of cool to look at, up to get it up close and personal look like that.
Helps me out a lot because every year I never know what year the cars are. This year they have a little thing in the window that tells you what year that they are. So we have some 1967 Fords going by right now from the Kitsap Mustang Club. They were formed in 1988. They contribute to many local charities and maintain a section of Highway 16 from litter. So they're having a Mustang car show on the Port Orchard waterfront on July 31st.
Perfect timing. Be nice out there.
It will, yeah. It will be beautiful. So we had some 1967. Now we're seeing the 68. I like a Mustang.
They are nice. Very, very sweet. There's a 68 Mustang GT. That looks newer. Is that newer?
This one, that one's a 1970. Well, this one's newer. We have a 2000 going by us now.
Not exactly a classic.
Not a classic, but a very cool looking car.
Very nice indeed.
There's a 2004. And a 2009. Oh, I like that one. They have the top off of that one for this morning.
Hey, as long as you're, if you're going to be out and about this afternoon, you're joining us for the parade broadcast on 1030 KMAS and MasonWebTV.com. Just in a couple of hours at Loop Field, the logging show, and you've been to a few of these logging shows, Amanda, haven't you?
Yeah, I've been to a few of the logging shows. It's going on at Loop Field right here in downtown Shelton. The logging show itself starts at 2. Also going on at Loop Field, they have all kinds of foods, arts and crafts, and vendors, and that goes on until 4. So there's pretty much stuff to do all weekend long around here.
I'm leaning toward the excitement of the logging show, and I'm leaning toward the food very heavily.
Yeah, I'm always leaning toward the food. Why not?
If you know what I mean, very heavily. But yeah, so that's going on this afternoon. Fireworks tonight at 10. Carnival is going on till 11 o'clock tonight, and that's going to be at the Gateway Center just off Olympic Highway North.
Kind of right behind McDonald's.
Yeah,
there.
Exactly. Right in that area. What do we got, Amanda?
We have the North Queens drill team going by now. They're attired in blue and white, and they are a familiar sight in the Pacific Northwest. They're from Linwood, so up north a little ways. The girls' ages range from 9 to 19, and the team formed in 1959, one of the area's oldest drill teams. I like the how they you can be a part of it from 9 to 19. So that 10 years of your life could be on that drill team. Very cool.
And they are stepping in unison. Let me tell you, they got it down, huh?
They do. I didn't hear one misstep that whole time. So.
4-H, and you know, doggone it, it escapes me what the 4-H's are. I think health, honesty.
I couldn't tell you.
That's all I can tell you.
Maybe happiness?
Happiness.
Why not?
And
maybe it'll tell us here.
Yeah. So this is our group from where, Amanda?
They're from right here in Mason County. They're helping us support the Mason Area Fair, July 19th,
heart,
29th
head,
through 31st.
Hands and health.
Heart, head, hands, and health. Mason4H.org.
Always a worthwhile organization, and they are promoting the Mason Area Fair on their float. And well, that's going to be here before we know
it. Yeah, 29th through the 31st of July, so not too far off.
Friday, Saturday, Sunday. And our next entry is a gentleman in a green outfit selling Mountain Dew and H2O for only $1.
Out of a Safeway cart.
He's going the wrong way, though.
He is.
He's going left to right on the radio dial, and the whole parade's going right to left on the radio. So he goes out and buys a case of Mountain Dew, and he's like, well, I'll sell each one
I'll make
a
some profit here. And if he doesn't, he can have a lot of drinks for later.
Exactly.
So.
And it looks like he might need the caffeine.
Coming up next, we have the Northwest chapter of the American Historical Truck Society. They collect and preserve antique trucks. Their annual truck show is at the Southwest Washington Fairgrounds coming up on August 6th. A lot of good stuff going on this summer.
I know. There's a lot of great activities right here in our region. Oh, what do we got coming up here, Amanda?
A 1946 Chevy belongs to Don Herrick of Shelton, Washington. That's a bright orange, some sort of vehicle.
Well, you know, the last weekend of this month, the last Sunday of this month, Amanda, are you going to be around for this? Yesteryear Car Club car show. It lines up and down Railroad Avenue.
It does. I think we actually have been out there before, haven't
we?
And we will be this year as well.
We're there with the event tent. In fact, our news director, Diedrich Allen, will be playing the tunes for you. Diedrich's going to become a DJ that day instead of doing the news.
Very nice.
He's going to be, yeah, push play on the CD player or the hard drive audio. He's going to be your DJ for the Yesteryear Car Club car show. 9 to 3 on Sunday the 28th.
Sunday
Amanda.
The 28th. There's some very awesome cars in that car show. Every one of them is a little different and so cool.
And it's really a club that in our area continues to grow and get new members, which is
Jerry
very
Cummings,
cool.
Member of the sales department at 1030 KMAS, helping push one of the yesteryear cars that didn't make it,
what
I guess.
What happened? Is that a Hyundai?
They forgot to fill up the gas tank before
the
parade,
word,
maybe.
Oh, my word, no. So we got like a nice 59 Impala going by, about a 65, 64 Buick Skylark. That is Lloyd. There goes Lloyd. Lloyd's the keeper of Paul Bunyan, in case you didn't know him.
Oh, I did not know.
Lloyd Prouty. That's a sweet little Nova, probably a 63 black Nova. Little Chevelle, about 1970.
Oh, they're throwing candy out of their car.
Hey, throw some candy over this way. You know what I'm talking about. Hey. Oh, they got by us.
They did. We missed out.
Now, there's another Mustang that wasn't with the group of Mustangs from before.
Well, that's because it's a member of the Yesteryear Car Club.
Is that a Nomad, Diedrich? Is that a Nomad? A sedan delivery. 59.
Bright yellow. I like that color.
Sweet. Well, the Yesteryear Car Club continues the parade of cars right to left on your radio dial. Let's take time out. And again, thank you to our sponsors for our broadcast this afternoon.
The Green Diamond Resource Company, Generation D Computers, The Roof Doctor, and Treasures Thrift Store.
Let's take time out on this parade broadcast for Mason County Forest Festival, 1030 KMAS.
Shake it up, shake it up, shake it up, shake it up.
All right, the Shelton Sports Hall of Fame, right, Amanda?
Yeah, we saw the Shelton Sports Hall of Fame. We saw Terry Dion, Jack Long go by?
Jack Stark.
Jack Stark, yes.
Former head coach of the Shelton High Climber football team.
Yes.
And three-time state champions, by the way, under his coaching.
Very nice. Going by right now is Dave Weaver, as you can hear, a 1977 Garrett skidder.
So that's a piece of logging equipment they call a skidder. Did you ever watch Axemen or no?
No.
Not so much?
Not so much.
I think the skidder is a device to pull logs up the hill. For example, like they can't maybe set up a spar pole.
Oh.
And I may be mistaken here, and I may come off as the biggest stupid face at the whole festival. I mean, here it is, Forest Festival, and I'm not sure what a skidder is, but that's what I think it does.
Just fake it till you make it, Randy.
I know. Exactly. Okay, so, Babe the Blue Ox. And Amanda, we've been over this a couple of times today. Even Paul Bunyan needs a friend, companion, and cohort.
Right.
So right now, there's a project underway, and we're going to tell you how you can help get a Babe the Blue Ox to go with our 30-foot Paul Bunyan that we have here in Shelton. Tell you more about it coming up at a special public challenge that's been put out by Green Diamond Resource Company.
Yes.
Are we ready to stir it up with McCleary's Bear Festival?
Yeah, the McCleary Bear Festival float. Not Beer Festival. It's in its 52nd year. The Bear Festival will be held July 9th in McCleary. With the float is the 2011 Queen Alexandria Keel, Princesses Caitlin Reed, Tatiana Schuetter, and Kayla Pierce.
Have you ever had the bear stew out there or no?
I have not.
Have you had bear?
Uh-uh.
Our fishing report, Steve Kramer.
Yes.
Kramer Tackle and Guide. Steve Kramer brought me by some bear pepperoni a little while back, and doggone it, I should have saved you a piece.
I don't know about that.
I'll tell you what, have you ever had buffalo or no?
Not, I don't think so.
It's very, very lean. Very lean is bear meat and buffalo, very tasty.
Ew.
Let me tell you, but when you go to McCleary for that bear festival,
you
can try the bear stew.
Okay, I will.
I'm just saying. Exceptional Foresters Incorporated.
Yes, EFI, and they would like to thank Mason County for the last 53 years. Without you, they would not be there to make a difference in the lives of so many.
I think their alarm's going off. Oh, wait.
EFI is a really, really, really great organization. They help out a lot of people. So they say thank you, and we say thank them.
So we thank you back.
Yes.
Amanda, I'd like to say something to you.
Okay.
Hi, you.
Hi, you. The West Seattle Hi, You Summer Festival. Sparkling Seattle is the theme for this float for 2011. The royalty is surrounded by all things that make Seattle sparkle. So there's the Space Needle up there. I see some skyscraper-like things. Taking a coffee break up front is Junior Court Queen Taylor Nichols. We also have Senior Court Queen Kelsey Bills and Senior Court Princesses Victoria Feroli and Rosemary Unit. Junior Princesses Riley Fredericks and Caitlin Lindell. I like that.
Yeah, that's a very nice, another one of the world-class floats that we have in the parade.
They have all things Seattle up there. The Space Needle, also Pike Place Market sign was up there.
Coffee.
Very
Starbucks,
nice. Starbucks.
Whatever, yeah. Mason County Rodeo, yeehaw! Now you've been out there, I know.
Yeah, I've been out there.
You've taken the festival in and the festivities for the rodeo for Mason County.
A time or two. We're welcoming our rodeo court, Junior Court Queen Beth Snyder and Junior Princesses Katie Jo Lester. Rodeo July 29th and 30th. And there's currently an equine illness epidemic that is affecting horses and could be life-threatening. So protecting their horses from this illness, the court arrives riding stick horses, and they have been awarded the 2011 Chairman's Award for Creativity.
And thank you for not bringing the diseased equestrians, equines, here to the parade. You know what I mean?
Yeah, probably a good idea.
I think. Is this part of the rodeo?
This is the Girl Scouts.
Ah.
Yeah. we had the Boy Scouts earlier, so now we get some Girl Scout action up here.
Western Washington Girl Scout Troop 40686.
Ooh, I like that dog. They have a husky out there.
Looks like they're out having a lot of fun. Now, were you a Girl Scout, Brownie, anything like
no,
that?
No, I was not.
I'm just asking.
I never was.
Don't get mad.
Oh, I'm not mad. I just never was.
Okay, so back to the Paul Bunyan thing and the
the
search for a companion for Paul, and it's not going to be cheap. Probably around $11,000 to have this thing built. But it's a Babe the Blue Ox companion piece to go with our tall Paul Bunyan. Diedrich, how tall is Paul? 25 if he's a foot? Okay, well, you've seen him in parades and festivals around the area. The drive is out there now to get a Babe the Blue Ox to go, like, on the trailer behind him, whatever.
Right.
So Patty Case and Green Diamond Resource Company have come forward kind of with a public challenge, and they will match all public donations up to $2,000. And a very generous offer from our friends at Green Diamond.
Very generous.
You can donate today where you see Paul Bunyan or at our Community Credit Union or Heritage Bank location.
Right. On the actual Paul Bunyan himself, there's a place where you can donate, correct?
Right. Okay. It's like a treasure chest. You put your donation right in there.
Grupo de Danza Folkloria Escuela Evergreen Folkloric Dance Group.
Whoa. Our tent's blown away.
Our tent's
away.
Blown
Take
away
over.
Here. Our tent's blown away, but we do see the folkloric group going by here. They're dressed in some very, very ethnic looking gear. They're doing some dancing for us as they walk by here. Very adorable. They are a dance group from Evergreen. We're still going on the broadcast as the tent's flying away. Coming up next, we have the Job's Daughters, Bethel 4-3 from Belfair, Washington, dressed up in some very, very pretty dresses for the parade today, waving at us as they go by, handing out some candy to all the youngsters out here. Oh, they're excited to be on the air here today.
Hi, how are you? What are you up to today?
Oh, Lynn, we're just with the Job's Daughters from Belfair and enjoying the parade and the good weather and invite everybody out to the booths. We're having a great time.
All right, thank you for stopping by to say hi.
Coming by right now, we have the Puget Sound Miata Club, Babe the Blue Miata Ox. So they're getting in the spirit of the Babe the Blue Ox.
Maybe that could be Paul's companion until the real Babe gets here.
Yeah, it's a possibility.
Or not, I don't know. Yeah, so here's the Miatas. Now, Diedrich, you owned a Miata, or you've driven one before, no?
No, I said for the Blue Ox, it would be more fun to drive.
Exactly. Those are neat little cars, those little Mazda Miatas. And they got the Miata Club of Puget Sound, right, Amanda?
Right. We're coming to the tail end of the parade here. I mean, we still have a few entries left, but we want to take some time to thank our parade sponsors, Green Diamond Resource Company, Generation D Computers, The Roof Doctor, and Treasure Thrift Store.
Proud sponsors of our 10:30 KMAS live parade broadcast for the 67th Mason County Forest Festival. Landscaping time, Amanda.
Lindsay's like Landscaping.
To do your own yard work, or would you like to have this kind of company come in and take care of it?
I think I would probably prefer them to help me out.
I mean,
every once in a while, it's okay to go out and plant some flowers and stuff, but definitely would be nice to have some help from. They look like they do a beautiful job based on their float.
Yeah, no kidding. That's nice. So that's Lindsay's Landscaping.
Yes, Lindsay's Landscaping. This was really a great turnout this year. There's a lot of people out. It's a beautiful, beautiful day. Couldn't ask for better weather. And the 67th Annual Forest Festival Parade.
Cheerleaders.
We have some cheerleaders going by here. They've been selling water all day.
Live on the radio with KMAS Radio, who wants to say what you're all doing today?
We're selling water for cheerleading.
Now, are you going to be out at the Loop Field and the different events throughout the weekend?
Yeah, we are. And
we'll
the car
show
tomorrow.
Okay, can we get a little Forest Festival cheer of some kind? No, not today. Whatever you want. Go Forest Fest, Forest Fest.
Forest Fest, Forest Fest.
SHS.
SHS.
All right, thank you, ladies. There they go. Selling the water for a fundraiser. Hey, one of our station sponsors is Ferguson Flowers.
Yeah, Ferguson Flowers and Gifts has a nice, it's like a wedding theme. They have a bride and a groom walking, and then followed by the van all decked out in pink and white tulle and stuff. So very, very nice. And coming by us right now is the Timbertown Derby from Shelton, Washington. The roller derby, they're on their roller skates. I could never, ever do that. I would fall flat on my face if I were to try to roller skate down Railroad Avenue. It would not be pretty. You're missing out on my roller derby thing here.
No, what's going on, Amanda? I was just getting some
cookies.
One of our listeners, Carolyn, just brought by some homemade cookies for
us. It's the Timbertown Derby, and I was just saying that if I were to try to rollerblade or roller skate down Railroad Avenue, it would not be a pretty sight.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah. No. Oh, and they had a little fall, it looks like.
So those are actual roller skates, not roller blades.
No, they're roller skates. Yeah, roller skates.
I don't know if my ankles could take, like, rollerblading.
I broke my wrist when I was younger rollerblading, and I've never really been the same since. And the final entry in the parade, Dan Griffey. Griffey for statehouse.com.
Wow, so that's it.
That's it.
Well, we do have a few more announcements we would like to make. Amanda, if you could give a recap of, let's talk about the rest of the events for the day.
Yeah.
Beginning with the logging show.
Yeah, the logging show going on at Loop Field right here in downtown Shelton this afternoon at 2. Also at Loop Field, plenty of food and crafts, arts and vendors until 4. And then later on tonight, fireworks. There's stores of the Western Log